Macron said we are going to invest like crazy in AI.
In terms of investment, $1.5 billion.
We're thrilled to have you here for this first AI day.
It seems like France is having very much an AI renaissance at the moment.
There's really a lot of opportunities to found some new AI companies.
Every year, there are 3,000 new startups in France. The talent pool is super impressive.
There's this really famous expression in France, we don't have petrol, but we have ideas.
What BaseImpact does is leverage technology like AI to address social issues at scale.
It is the combination between search and social media.
Nabla Copilot helps physicians to spend more time with their patient and less time on paperwork.
Enable any seller with studio quality photos. We do that using AI.
There is so much talent in the French AI ecosystem, and it really seems to be kind of commercializing and turning into super exciting startups at a quite rapid pace.
But I think the main reason why people relocate is for the food.
The core reason of the momentum we're seeing right now is that there has been a pool of very strong scientific talent. If we dig deeper of why there's been a match made in heaven, probably trace back to the mathematical focus that French education has had historically. In some countries, it's everything about history. In some others, it's everything about law. In France, it's everything about math.
The Minitel was born in the 1980s in France, and it was at-home device and an ancestor of internet. People could go onto their device and browse French content.
You could get the information on a company, the opening hours of a restaurant, you could make reservations, you could book tickets. You could do a certain number of things that you then were able to do on the internet in the late 80s, early 90s.
What is interesting with the Minitel story is that it was a true demonstration that French entrepreneurs, French engineers are able to dream big, but at the same time can also lose themselves if they think of their products within the French borders.
France was famously late in catching the first wave of internet because it had the Minitel. We need to not be late on this one.
So I'm originally from Thailand, and because I got a scholarship, I arrived in France when I was 17 years old. I think France is awesome.
Wow.
So what they first do is that we help retailers predict the customers' behaviors. What are they going to buy? How they react to different things? How they react to the change of the price so that they can maximize their financial and also maximize the customers' happiness.
Dust is an AI assistant platform for modern, fast-growing teams that want to get work to work better. We bring together large language models and private information that companies want to allow their teammates to take advantage of.
I recall thinking of the name Dust while driving and hearing another one bites the dust. And I was like, okay, dust and bites. Ah, that's interesting because it's the bites, the computer bites. There's probably something there, dust bites, bite dust. Oh. It's going to be dust.
The level of ambition of people who are working in the space that's very different from a decade ago.
There is this momentum, this hunger, this excitement. 5 years ago, there were a lot of resources that our companies here were lacking to be able to really compete on a global level. I actually think now we're seeing talent that wants to move to France, and that's something we hadn't seen before. We're also seeing the government making a big push and making visas for not only founders, but also tech talent more accessible and easier to have. The funding landscape is probably the best one in Europe.
AI companies are such interesting businesses. Monetization is really important for these companies. We're generally seeing them offering paid products from very early on, and we see 70% of the AI companies building on Stripe. We're delighted to partner with them, and we are building the billing system and the payment system to support all these companies.
To me, AI will be very comparable to the computer because it was pretty hard to use a computer. As the technology matured, it impacted more and more people and eventually made everybody much more efficient.
I feel that there's a rational fear that AI is going to replace many people. It's just, I think, the classic reactions people have to new technology.
Now, not only scientists have this power of predicting the future, there are a lot of AI solutions that give this power to the hands of people who didn't do science. And that's what's wonderful about this. And we are part of this movement.